different brain regions become activated at different times.
We're developing a method of neurobiofeedback in which people can see their own brain activity in real time in our scanner. And that method, in general, will be useful in studying how to perhaps control addiction, or control pain, or control hunger.
Today was Chancellor's Research Day. We have this once a year, when we have a bunch of professors come together and share with what they're passionate about. Not just what they teach in classrooms, but what really makes them passionate about being an academician.
All of my work relates to expression and imagination, as it helps us to live our lives. And because of my husband's illness, I became more aware that literature is not just my vocation as a poet and my bread and butter as a professor. It is, you could almost say, my church. It's what sustains me.
Looking at archaeologically waste and products, I can tell a designer, architect, engineer who thought they had a great creation in the first place, and the fact that it ended up in a dump, to me, tells me that's bad design. And so by looking at the end of life of products, I can help design the next generation of materials to make them more environmentally responsible.
People who are incarcerated who take college classes have the lowest recidivism rates of any programs that we have been able to study in the correctional system. So making higher education available to people in prison who are eligible for those classes is an investment in public safety in the state of New Jersey, but it's also an investment in the future for the children and families of those people when they get released from prison.
I wanted to represent the entire campus, and we have a very diverse campus. So I wanted to be able to take things all the way from nursing school to the law school to the people from the business school to science and humanities. We had everything here, so people from areas where you may not interact with such things can actually see what other people are doing across campus.